up, y'all? Wasn't y'all expecting this to be how the breakdance music was? Like, shouldn't that have been what they came out with? Like, that is the ultimate breakdancing song. What's up, everybody? What's up? Yeah, that breakdance was sad. When you hear that music, it's like, man, y'all want to see some real breakdance, so just go watch Breaking. Happy Tuesday. I went to the gym today. I did my 30 minutes on the elliptical. Whooped my butt. I did like on level 5 towards the end, but man, my heart rate was up there. My heart rate on level 2 is like 160. Like, that's a lot. That thing, that Stairmaster is no freaking joke, man. But I'm doing it. We gonna see what we get, you know. I mean, my butt is still intact. It's not, you know, getting... Can't do too much running and your butt start going away. I just can't have that. So it's still intact. Things are still on the right path. And I did some treadmill, sat in that hot sauna, came home, ate leftover barbecue, and watched some show called Full Circle on Max. And it's a show, and it has like a lot of big name actors in it, but like this show makes absolutely no sense. Like, I'm still trying to get the plot. Somebody kidnapped a son, and the guy was rich and stole recipes and became a rich chef, and I don't know. I'll watch more tomorrow maybe and let y'all know what's popping. I know the DNC convention was tonight, so I kind of scoured the timeline a little bit to see what they was yapping about. But yeah, let's go ahead and get into this news. President Biden condemns Donald Trump for calling the U.S. a failing nation. Sanders sends a wrong message to world leaders. He says we're losing. He's a loser. He's wrong. President Biden has a DNC crowd give a round of applause to his wife Jill Biden, saying she still leaves me both breathless and speechless. It's like, Biden, yes, she left you speechless, because when you don't know what to say, she helped you out, big dog. He said she walks down the stairs, and I still get that going boom, boom, boom. Yeah, okay. These jokes are going to write themselves, so just too many in that. Joe Biden is the OG girl dad. His daughter Ashley Biden says at the DNC, he told me I can be anything and I can do anything. Okay. Of course his family and children were there. People gave Biden a 76% as far as his presidency goes. First Lady Jill Biden reflects on her late son Beau working with Kamala when they were both state attorneys. He told me at the dinner table one night, Mom, she's special, someone to keep your eye on. And he was right. Hillary Clinton says the future is here. It's in our grasp. Hallie Duvall, a Kentucky woman who is pregnant at 12 years old after being assaulted by her stepfather, speaks at the DNC and calls out abortion bans. She says Donald Trump calls it a beautiful thing. She says, what's so beautiful about a child having to carry her parents' child? That is a very, very good speech. Somebody, the union dude came out, said Trump is a scab. You know that's gonna get the union people riled up. Hillary says, together we put a lot of cracks in the highest, hardest glass ceiling. It's gonna be a lot of speed stuff about this. Tonight, a look at voters in households with a union member. Harris currently leads Trump at 58%. Alexandra Cortez said, you cannot leave your country if you only fight for the wealthy and big business. To love this country is to fight for the people. Um, Two women who denied medical care while undergoing miscarriages and another who became pregnant at 12 was some of the people that spoke at the DNC. Let's see. Most of the talk, like I said tonight, will probably really be about the DNC, baby. The DNC convention. There's nothing else going on in the world, I suppose. Six people, including two Americans and a British tech entrepreneur, Mike Lynch, are missing after a luxury yacht sank off of the coast of Sicily. That ain't good. Israel has accepted a U.S. proposal for the sought-after ceasefire and hostage release agreement and has called on Hamas to do the same. Anyone paying attention during the summer over tourism is familiar with escalating consequences around the world, traffic jams in paradise, reports of hospitality workers living in tents. Yeah, it gets rough. Those people work so hard too. Former Republican Congressman George Santos pled guilty to wire fraud and aggravated identity theft in his federal fraud case. He faces up to 8 years behind bars and owes at least $370,000 in restitution. I feel like George could make that easy on a reality show. They'll let him out. Let's see. It says, as Democrats return to Chicago for the convention, thousands of demonstrated on the street evoke memories of the violent 1968 clashes with the Popo. While today's protests are expected to be less volatile, the issues connected to past and present activism remain similar. I did not know Phil Donahue was still alive, but he passed away at 88. And Phil, he was, I didn't even know he was still alive. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky says his forces captured nearly 500 square miles of Russia's Kherson region. Two women passed away in severe flooding in Connecticut after a powerful storm battered parts of the northeast on Sunday, washing away roads, bridges, and submerging cars. Trump says he will accept this year's election outcome if it's going to be fair and free. Flying with the U.S. will soon require an extra document that's more secure than a state-issued driver license or ID if you don't want to lug around your passport with you. Y'all still ain't got that real ID. Some protesters breached a security fence in the security perimeter of the DNC on Monday afternoon. Former President Donald Trump shared the AI-generated images of women wearing Swifties for Trump t-shirt to his Truth Social on Sunday, including a satirical post that claimed Taylor Swift fans were turning to Trump. Yeah, that was the AI for real. I said Kamala is unveiling her economic plans. Gloucester Charalis, a former NFL offensive lineman and Boston College football star, is accused of urinating on another passenger on a Delta Airlines flight. What was going on with you, bro? Why did you do that? What happened? At least two people, we talked about that. Burning Man's allure appears to be fading with festival goers as tickets are still available ahead of its August 25th kickoff. I don't know one Burning Man song. I probably do if I heard it, but I don't know one. Boy Meets World actress Danielle Fisher Topanga revealed that she was recently diagnosed with breast cancer. Hopefully she overcomes that. There's some bad news ahead for the nation's car owners with a new report forecasting that auto insurance, one of the biggest drivers, will have one of inflation. I can't even hardly read that sentence because it just don't even sound right and read right. That is not cool. Federal prosecutors have charged Trayvon White, a member of the D.C. City Council, with one count of bribery, alleging he agreed to accept over $150,000 in exchange for stealing millions of dollars in potential government contracts. You can't be that dumb, can you, Trayvon? I mean, I know some people get away with it, but we don't. The first of 2024's fourth consecutive supermoons, the blue moon, will reach peak illumination on Monday and will shine brightly through Wednesday. I don't know if I've seen the moon again. I don't know. I need to pay attention. I keep forgetting to. There's a Labor Day weekend is expected to cap off a record-breaking travel during the summer. Newly released body cam video shows how New Jersey police pew-pewed 25-year-old Victoria Lee in her home last month. Lee's family had called 911 about a mental health crisis. Y'all gotta stop calling the police about that. I'm telling you, y'all got to stop. I don't know if y'all could hire like some kind of bouncer or somebody strong to go over and defuse, but you'd almost rather do that than call the police at this point. Maybe somebody should start a business on that, you know, because they have people that work with like mental people at those facilities. Like they have people for that. Maybe people should start looking into that if your family member has those kind of issues. Two people were missing and we talked about that, but now the news is starting to repeat itself. I don't know if I liked anything today, y'all. It was not anything exciting. Let's see what I got. This was funny. Why is she trying to mow down her sister? That was not cool, sister. She knew exactly what she was doing when she got in that car. General Hospital actor Johnny Wachter, two men charged with his unalivement. Chappelle Roan, I'm a random bee and so are you. Stop crossing boundaries. Don't know who that girl is. Random B, I guess. Young Gravy on Hawk Tool Girl. I wasn't asking you out in your DMs, but you're missing out. The Valley's Jax Taylor ready to be number one guy in the group again, leaving treatment soon. I've never watched one episode of Vanderpump Rules or The Valley. I watch a lot of shows, but that one just doesn't interest me. Nev Schulman fights back tears. Accident shouldn't have happened at all. Lee Daniels, Jesse relationship is complicated, but I would cast him again. Don't do it, Jesse. I feel like a lot of people don't understand, but I feel like Lee was not paying Jesse enough, and Jesse, I don't know, because a lot of people complain about how low Lee's pay is, and the whole thing is unfortunate. Matthew Perry's unalignment DEA strips charge doctors no more writing prescriptions. The Kill Bill star Michael Madsen arrested for domestic violence. He's always had a really crazy life, that man. He's still going, huh? Flavor Flav is partying in Vegas with the Team USA. Yeah, boy. That's what the article says. I didn't say that one. Sexy Red, put my coochie juice on your lips, launches her first lip gloss. Yeah, the name of some of them was cray cray. Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie, Shiloh granted a name change. She's just Jolie now. TikTok star Nikki Ciampa files for divorce from Pierre Boo. Bianca Tesori even covered up, still looks like she doesn't have clothes on for a family shopping trip. Bianca, this is just her outfits now. Maybe she just really hates clothes. New Jersey bus driver, spit happens, but not on my route. Passenger beat down, called on video. They both got arrested for that. Motorbike racer star Louis O'Regan passed away at 43 after crash at the Manx Grand Prix. Diddy trafficking accuser files a police report. Cops are sharing info with the feds. I think this was out of Miami. It's been quiet from Diddy, so I'm just waiting to see what. Donahue looks so different without his glasses. Wow. Those glasses really were his personality. Oscar De La Hoya wild with a banana hammock dance with Holly Saunders. Oscar's still kicking it. Fortunately, an Oakland mom was unalived in broad daylight. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle hit the dance floor in Colombia, hugging and kissing. Lonzo Ball's fans should expect me back this season. Hasn't played since 22. Man, they were the most overhyped basketball players. And their dad, he did his thing. But, yeah, they flopped. 90 Day Fiancé star Sophie Sierra. I'll take a rose from Chad Johnson. Cozy concert date with Bachelorette alum. Don't know who that is. I just saw Chad Johnson and I was hoping she wasn't talking about Ocho Cinco, but it wasn't. All right. Let's see what else we got out here, y'all. Let's see what else we got. Georgia Hospital allegedly loses part of a man's skull during surgery, then charges him $19,000 to build a new one. That's crazy as heck. That is crazy as heck. I don't know what Oscar talking about. Man who pulled a pew-pew on a Burger King worker went and take drugs for payment gets 143 years in prison. Wow. Somebody said bro could have sold the drugs and then bought the food. See, he was probably on those drugs he was trying to sell. So Crystal Kaiser was sentenced to 11 years in prison for unaliving her alleged trafficker. This is in Milwaukee. She had received 11 years of confinement and 5 years of supervision for the 2018 unalivement of Randall Voller. She was credited for 570 days served, and she was 17 at the time, where she pew-pewed Voller and set his house on fire and stole his BMW. She avoided a potential life sentence by pleading guilty to a reduced charge. Luckily, she did five, so she can get out in six. Today is Nate Dogg's birthday. Nobody does it better. No, nobody. All right. I think we are ready for some Reddit. Ready for some Reddit? Won't you do it? Won't you get it? I don't know why that clicked on that. All right, let's see what we got. What difficult truths? The sooner you accept them, the better your life will be. That there will be some hard days, and there will be some bad days and sad days, but trouble don't last always. Trouble don't last always. That some people won't like you, and sometimes for no reason. Absolutely. If somebody don't like you, might be curious to know why people care. Just let them go. There'll always be someone better looking, better educated, younger, more experienced, more intelligent, or wealthier than you. Do your best to live without regret. Have empathy and kindness. Give when you can, expecting nothing in return. Focus on your heart value more than what others have. always somebody who got more. Just because you're right doesn't mean people will agree with what with you and might work against you either way. My wife struggles with this. She has an idea that works and gets the company more money, but the owner and other workers are against it because they disagree with it, even with evidence that it works better. All the data in the world won't change the mind of a person who won't listen. Maybe she needs to go to a different company. Once you're an adult, there really isn't anyone you can 100% depend on except for yourself. There will still be people in your life to lean on, but everyone has their limits in how they can help you. You can't change the past, but you can decide what to do next. Amen. Not everything is a lesson. Sometimes you just fail. Happiness isn't a constant state, and that's normal. You and you alone are your only best ally and worst enemy all at the same time. Once you come to terms with that, things will start to make sense. Very good advice. You can love someone who isn't gonna love you back. Don't get into arguments on the internet. No one will change their mind. Avoid seeking people's approval. Cheap shoes will do you no favor. When you're young, it feels a small thing to turn your back on society, but as years go on, it could be a lonely place out there. If they wanted to, they would. You're responsible for your life. Blaming others for your problems might feel good temporarily, but it doesn't change your situations. Taking responsibility empowers you to make changes and improve your circumstances. Nothing is forever. Everything changes. Yeah, some good advice, y'all. What is the hardest thing you've accomplished after a night of no sleeps? The list is long. Having a baby, moving, working, driving, all the above. Now you're so tired when you're driving and you don't know how you made it to your destination. I've done that a lot, and that is not a good thing, but I have. Another 14-hour ER shift, 12-hour Black Friday cashier shift, was worried I would oversleep and get fired. That's sad. Watched my mom suffer from Alzheimer's. At one point, she was asking for her mom, and I told her that her mom had passed away. She responded as if she was hearing it for the first time and had a complete breakdown. There were several such instances that occurred the last 2 years of her life, and it was absolutely the hardest thing to watch. Man, I can't even imagine watching someone you love get sick, keep a newborn alive. I did deliver the news to my grandparents in their 90s that their son, my father, had just passed away from cancer. I had a newborn a week old and had agreed to watch my cousin's 3 kids. That was the day I decided one and done. I know that's right. A lot of people are talking about birth, taking a bar exam, working another whole day, then cycling home. Do not recommend. Sobriety. The first week of quitting was made extra difficult by lack of sleep, and then lack of sleep was always an excuse to give up and keep drinking, but I somehow made it through in the last try, and today is 441 days. Amen. Just gotta make it through the night. What is something that you're unwilling to compromise on now that everything is so expensive? I'll always have to have name brand ketchup, no matter how expensive it gets. That's just, and cheese. I can't have no fake cheese that tastes like vegetable oil. My toiletries and skincare finally found what worked for me. Yeah, if your skincare works, heating in the winter. Yeah, heating and AC is just, I mean, you gotta know a guy, but that's something you have to have. I refuse to buy margarine instead of butter, even though it's $6.50 a pound here. You gotta have the real butter. I can't compromise on my monthly therapy sessions. Tires, good tires are worth every penny. If you know a guy, though. Running a window AC unit and 3 fans all day. My husband loves his fans. Somebody said my favorite ice cream, my house, my mattress. You gotta have a good mattress. Yep. Heinz ketchup. I knew it was gonna be there. Somebody said movie tickets. I don't know. Movies is trash these days. Somebody said groceries, taco seasoning. You don't need name brand taco seasoning. Although I buy taco seasoning. Taco seasoning hasn't gotten that expensive yet to where I feel like, you know. Alright, let's get into the story times. Sometimes Reddit be asking the same questions. I'm still mad at TikTok for deleting a lot of stories I've saved. I did not like that. So this lady was having a baby and a piece of the ceiling fell down on her.
In the hospital, literally fucking fell on me.
Look at me. Let the record reflect, we will not be suing.
I don't know about that. The ceiling fell on me while I was sleeping. And everything. This is your pillow. Okay.
Oh, this used to be our nurse's station, actually.
Her husband is straight tripping. Her husband is tripping. What's wrong with him? Someone said the way one of the wings would be named after me. Somebody said her labor is about to be free. Somebody said that not suing the hospital is paying for university. Somebody said the way a lawyer would be waiting in my room by the time someone got me. Someone says, he says we're not suing, but sir, are you the one on the bed preparing to give birth? Exactly. And then just think about all that dust in that room. The fact they still got her in that room is wild. But her husband is tripping. She should not even have posted that part of the video.
My friend just had a baby. You see it? Oh, what happened to it? Piggy, she's on FaceTime. Oh my gosh. It's like an ugly little baby.
What's
Oh, look at my friend's new baby.
What?
My friend's new baby. Oh my god, what's that?
You have FaceTime.
What?
You have FaceTime.
What's this? What's this? Oh, look at my friend's baby.
Oh.
Oh, she's on. She's
on. Beautiful.
Isn't it cute?
What the fuck?
Dad, my friend is on FaceTime.
Oh, so cute. What the fuck? Wow. I've never seen a cuter baby.
Isn't she beautiful?
Oh. Isn't it so cute?
Yeah.
Mom.
So
FaceTime.
Oh. Oh. My friend just had...
When I grew up... I've watched this so many times, which is so ridiculous. It always is funny to me. And the old lady was like, isn't it cute? She's like, what? And she's like, yeah. Man, I don't know. These videos are so old, but I can't stop laughing at these.
Y'all remember how I was telling y'all about 304 talk? Here's somebody y'all gotta... Just watch.
I feel really bad for the hotel staff that are coming to clean this room because those sheets are soaked. We booked in for a waterfall and I tugged back like three of these hydrolites. That shit was gushing. Like, he wanted me to sit on his. Within 2 seconds of that, I was literally pouring out. Always drink the clear ones of these, hydrolite or pedialyte, if you want the perfect waterfall. But yeah, he loved the gush on his face, which pretty much made him finish straight away. But he was done and washed out the door within 40 minutes. All right, let's count. Sorry, 900. Yeah, that makes sense. 2,900 for 40 minutes work. So he paid $1,500 for the booking and then $1,000 extra for the waterfall. He also paid $200 for the hotel and...
Y'all, these a 304 is HOE if you don't know. But girls are getting tips from sex tips from them. I still don't believe in like the whole squirting thing. I still think it's pee, but maybe it'll taste like Pedialyte. I don't know.
No, I got this part. Excuse me, sir. I just got a quick question.
You got a 100% Georgia boy right here, man. Born and raised.
100%.
On the south side, Cleveland Avenue.
Sir.
Look, this brother right here, look at his nappy ass right there, man. He need a haircut. Somebody please get some clipper, man. His shoe bigger than here. Give me his shoe bigger than here. Look, he represents Georgia.
So what's your experience like being like ugly in Atlanta? That's all I'm saying.
Ugly in Atlanta? I've been bad in Atlanta.
Okay.
Real ugly in Atlanta. Good, bad, ugly.
I think that'll be our time today for the documentary. All right, appreciate it.
He roasted the heck out of that dude. That stuff was hilarious. He said he ain't even representing Georgia. Dude had an African chain on. Somebody said he lit you up real quick. Somebody said Robert Downey Jr. in Tropic Thunder. Somebody said you can't convince me you ain't called the cops on him for that. He probably did because he got roasted. Somebody said it hit different when the homeless people roast you. That is hilarious.
Y'all, it is a terrible day to be an Aces fan. Sparks' Dierre Kayambi has just officially filed a lawsuit against the WNBA and the Las Vegas Aces. She's completely in the right. Hi, I'm Malia. I'm your friend for all things women's basketball, and I'm going to break down why this could be the end of the Las Vegas Aces. In order to understand this lawsuit, you have to understand Dierre Kayambi's history with the Aces. She's been with them since she was drafted in 2015 when they were the San Antonio Stars and became the Las Vegas Aces. She also moved with them. She has a long history with this team. In 2022, in an effort to prevent Dierica from becoming a free agent, Aces offered her a bunch of incentives to stay with them. Some of them include providing housing for Hamby and paying her daughter Amaya's tuition. Approximately 3 weeks after signing this contract, Dierica found out she was pregnant. In August of that year, Dierica informed the Aces coach Becky Hammond. In September of that year, Dierica helps lead the Aces to a WNBA championship. But here's where things took a turn. September 20th, 2022, Dierica decided to announce to the world that she was pregnant. From here, I read the entire lawsuit, and Dierica claimed that everything started to change after she publicly announced her pregnancy. She noticed that the Aces were no longer paying for her daughter Amaya's tuition. On October 1st, the general manager of the Aces told her that she had to vacate the team-provided housing that she was living in. She was given no reason as to why. Now, this is the part that has been most talked about and viral all over. You can pause to read here, but Erica Hamby said that she received a call from Becky Hammond, and it did not go well. She claimed that Becky Hammond intimidated her, bullied her, wrongfully accused her of not taking the proper precautions to not get pregnant. Also that Hammond wrongfully accused her of signing her 2-year extension contract, knowing that she was pregnant, even though she found out she was pregnant 3 weeks later. Told her she could pick a place like Los Angeles or Atlanta, or she'd trade her, and essentially terminated her from the Aces. After it had been publicly announced that Dierica had been traded to the Sparks, she posted this to Instagram. Said being traded is a part of the business, being lied to, bullied, manipulated, and discriminated against is not. Again, you can pause to read. If it wasn't clear, it is an EEOC violation to fire somebody or terminate somebody because they're pregnant. Still, Becky claims that this was a basketball decision. After her wrongful termination, an investigation was opened up against the Aces. Start of the 2023 season, Becky Hammond was suspended from 2 games without pay, and the WNBA revoked a first-round pick that the Aces had in the 2025 draft. Obviously, the investigation did not come back non-conclusive. Found enough evidence to charge the Aces and Becky. But for people who are wondering why she's suing now, just in May 2024, she received the right to sue. I'm not a lawyer. I don't understand law stuff. A lot of these investigations and legal cases take time. Does anybody stop to consider why anytime the Sparks play the Aces, they just gain this extra strength and are able to beat them? At the end of the day, the way that the Aces and Becky treated Dierica is terrible and wrong. I want to put out there that after Dierica gave birth to her son Legend, she played all 40 games with the Sparks. Not only that, but she was a greatly improved player. I mentioned
athletes and giving birth and having to get back and, it's crazy. I mean, it's hard enough like being in the military and giving birth because you literally only have 6 weeks to lose that weight. So I can't even imagine if I was making money, like, not that the WNBA makes that much money, but still, like, you have so much stress to get back in shape. And, I mean, WNBA, like, any sport, any athlete, like, as a woman, getting back to your shape that you were is just, like, beyond stressful. But, yeah, EEOC always has to do an investigation before they give you the right to sue. So, hopefully, she gets what's due to her.
Carry on. And Shawnee, so the issue that I have is I heard that y'all asked your church for $4 million in donations to help rebuild the church. I was told after the hurricane hit in Houston, you guys shut down the church indefinitely because the roof collapsed, and then you asked your members for $4 million. I need $4 million. For $4 million to help rebuild their church. Is that true? Rumor on the street is Shawnee Man down there being a dusty, which I'll call them, the black dusties, begging. And you said they want $1 million. Shawnee want $1 million. Well, Shawnee should have spiritually married Carry On and spiritually took his last name the same way August Alsina spiritually married Jada Pinkett. Remember when we dropped that wine? Okay. She was still getting her $50,000 a month and spousal support from her ex-husband, who got $4 million. You have a television show, you had a lot going for yourself, and this man lives off of donations. And when the city of Houston loses, which means they lose power because of the politicalness behind the power companies and stuff like that, their houses cave in. Why do they have to rebuild the church before they rebuild the house that they're in, that you claim is God's house? If it was God's house, he wouldn't have blew it down. They asking y'all for $4 million to rebuild a church when this church is a 501c3, which means they have a low tax liability. These people dress nice. Shawnee, they paying their salary. They fly private everywhere they go. What was you doing with the money? Carry On, you're supposed to be writing books like Joel Osteen and T.D. Jakes. What is up, bruh? But where is your insurance? Where is your insurance? Did you not keep the building up to code? What's going on? Because insurance won't pay out if you didn't do what you're supposed to do to keep the building up to code. Something is not right. Y'all better hit Carry On when I ain't got it.
I'm surprised Shawnee don't have $4 million. I mean, she had her ha and still has Basketball Wives. I know she's a producer on there. I don't know how much it's still her show, but see what the people are saying. Somebody said I would have stayed married to Shaq. Where's the insurance money? They better pray about it. Somebody said 50,000 in alimony. I'd never marry again. They said Shawnee left Shaq for this. I mean, Shawnee been and left Shaq before him. Somebody said they better call FEMA. What happened to the tithes and the offerings? Yeah, they say Shawnee's net worth is worth 35 million. Billing funds and insurance is what is used for this purpose. Somebody said if I was her, I would have told my husband not to do that because you know them people going to talk about me. Somebody said ask Tyler Perry. Yeah. Ask Tyler.
I'm not a lawyer, but Susan Lorenz was found guilty today for killing her neighbor, AJ Owens. The trial only lasted 4 days, but here are some clips to give you context as to how it went. The first clip is from the opening statement of Susan's defense team. Now, her team was claiming self-defense and that she was in fear of her life. And in using that defense, in their opening statements, they highlight some of Susan's ailments.
June 2023. She was almost 59 years old, 58, almost 59 years old, but her body was much older than a 59. She suffered from many, 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 many medical infirmities. You will hear that she had issues with her knee that caused countless surgeries that involved damaged tendons and ligaments in her right knee and a partial knee replacement in the left knee. Her right knee literally goes backwards. 2019 that required invasive spine surgery, and she has diminished her left feet as a result of that spine cord injury. You hear that in 2021 she had a cervical fusion because of that car accident in 2019. She also had an aneurysm on her kidney. She had a torn muscle in her left shoulder and torn rotator cuff in 5 places. You hear that she also had a herniated thoracic disc and carpal tunnel in both hands, and had surgery on her left hand because of it in 2022. You also hear that she is a survivor of
a... She had carpal tunnel in both hands, but that did not stop her from pulling that hammer back to that woman.
Cancer, and she's in remission. Needless to say, with all this physical ailments, still 59 years old.
Almost 59 years old, June 2023. Inherently, she was
Now, the first few witnesses called to the stand were people from the neighborhood. The first was a father in the neighborhood who was outside playing with the kids in the field next to Susan's house that day. And following him, his son got on the stand to testify about what he saw.
I want to take you to June 7th, the day of the shooting. Were you playing with the kids in that open field that day?
I was. Yes, sir.
While children were playing in that open field, did there come a time that the defendant came out and began to record you and the children?
Yes, sir.
Did Israel have a tablet with him?
Well, either a tablet or a phone, something. He had something. I was playing with the kids, and whenever he approached me, because I was in the middle trying to guide, I had them all divided into two teams. So he said, you know, I was literally paying attention to the both team, and then Israel asked me if I can watch his phone or tablet. And I'm like, I cannot because I'm paying attention to everyone else. I'm calling out numbers. And it's like, I'm just going to place it here. I'm going to leave it here. I'm like, well, you got to be responsible for your own things. I was right at the middle field, in the middle of the field. And then he just left it there. I just kept playing with the kids. And then right in the middle of the open field, yes, sir, where I was standing. Once we got done playing and everything, and I got tired because I behaved like a kid, but I don't have the energies. I went back to my apartment. It was about to get dark, yes, sir. I started playing on my phone, being on Facebook. I heard like a firecracker, which in my military experience, and I thought it was a firecracker because of the, it wasn't that loud. It sounded weird, but then I'm like, nah, it can't be a shot. It's gonna be a firecracker. I didn't do anything. I just went back to my phone, and then I heard banging on my door. I open it up. I see my son panicking, screaming, and literally just panicking. He couldn't talk. He said she got shot. She shot her. I try to calm him down to see, try to gather more information. If someone got shot, I mean, military experience, I'm like, well, I need to hurry up to see if I can help someone. I went outside. I went towards, it's what we as a law enforcement and everything, we have stimulus. I went where the noise was. So I went towards the noise right at the corner where the, near the basketball hoop was at. Right at the corner, and I heard everyone screaming and the kids crying. Isaac and my mom. I immediately keep an eye on Mrs. apartment just in case. I mean, you never know. I'm just situation awareness. I started scanning for open wounds, and I heard she got shot, so I was just scanning for open wounds to try to help her out.
How old are you?
I'm 13.
You remember seeing Isaac and his mom walking over to the lady who shot her's house?
Yes, I was at the basketball hoop. She looked mad. I remember her cursing.
Did you see Isaac and Izzy's mom go up to the lady who shot her store?
Yes, I was beside my house when it happened.
Were you in that general area when you saw Isaac and Izzy's mom at the door?
Yes, I remember her banging on the door. She was banging in a mad type of bang. I remember her saying, open up the door. She was saying the B word and the F word.
Did you ever see Isaac and Izzy's mom reach for the door handle?
No.
Did you ever hear Isaac and Izzy's mom say, I'm going to kill you?
No. After she banged on the door, I remember hearing a gunshot. I saw Isaac's mom run and yelling, call 911. I went to my dad. I ran to my dad.
Now, as I said, Susan was claiming self-defense, and in doing so, her team really emphasized how angry and loud and scary AJ's banging on the door was when she came to Susan's house. So in cross, they asked a lot of the neighbors about this.
AJ was really mad, wasn't she?
Yes.
She seemed really angry, right? And then after that, she started banging on Miss Susan's regular door, right?
Yes.
And it was like bang, 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 hard, right? And she was doing it with her fists, right?
Yes.
She was screaming, right?
Yes.
Yes. And you refer to that neighborhood as the hood?
Yes.
The landlord's rent to some unsavory people?
Yes.
Now, the banging was so hard, it was shaking the walls in your house, right?
Yes.
And you were scared.
Oh, yes.
And while this banging was happening, you heard voices, right?
Mm-hmm.
And the voices were loud.
Very loud.
The voices were aggressive.
Yes.
The voice sounded like when someone gets really mad and really wants to scream, right?
Yes.
And it sounded like it was coming from outside, right?
Yes.
You were talking about a prior instance that you saw where Ajika threw a sign.
Yes.
Ajika had walked onto Susan's property and picked that sign up.
Yes.
And the sign hit Susan on the shin.
Yes.
And then Susan fell to the ground.
Yes.
And the police came out and talked to them.
Yes.
Another interesting witness that testified was the landlord of the units that Susan and AJ lived in. And as a reminder, one of Susan's major complaints was that the kids were always in the field next to her house. They were trespassing, they were loud, and they were antagonizing her. But here's what the landlord had to say about that open field next to Susan's house.
There's an open field to the right of that quadplex that you're facing, am I correct?
Yes.
Do you own that property next to this quadplex?
The majority of the property is owned towards the upper duplex, quadplex.
Okay, so the majority of that open field is owned by the other quadplex owner?
Correct.
And that's not you?
No.
Understood. Do you have any property rights to that larger portion of the open field than other quadplex to the right?
No, I do not.
Are you able to tell anybody that they can't go on that property?
I cannot.
Have you ever, are you aware that there are children that sometimes play in that open field?
Yes.
Have you ever personally told any of those children they weren't allowed to do that?
I have not.
Why wouldn't you be able to do that?
It's not my property.
Okay.
So when police confiscated Susan's phone, they discovered that there were some videos from the day of the incident in there. Now, they are very short videos, but it is what led up to the event, and it's what she recorded from her phone.
Why is she recording that? It's just you.
Is there a photo tape or a video at 7:58 and 59 seconds?
Here. There is.
Oh my God, there's nothing to record!
PM.
We did.
Did you locate a video at 8:33 and 59 seconds PM?
We did.
Now, lastly, I want to show you a video of a mock-up that from an expert that the defense team called. It was played in court, and I'm only showing you because I found it interesting.
It is a 3D visualization that was created for this incident.
Yeah, the whole thing is
so scary. After all of that and more, Susan Lorenz was found guilty of manslaughter today. We'll wait.
Yeah, she got found guilty. It's unfortunate on all sides, but you cannot, this is another example, like, people, and I get it, people can't always afford to live places, there's gonna be kids around, but you literally can't just blast somebody from inside your house. Like, when that day comes that we can do that, this world's gonna be in a whole lot of trouble.
Everybody, y'all wanna hear something random? Michael Jordan and Kevin Hart are beefing. Okay, I lied. It's more like Michael Jordan just doesn't like Kevin Hart. Why? Because Michael Jordan has a problem. He takes things personally. He hits up Kevin one day. He's like, Kevin, like, yeah. He's like, hey, my boy, I'm doing a charity event. Can you come over and just, like, you know, host it? Kevin said, absolutely. So Kevin Hart goes over. He starts hosting the event. It's all rich people, but he don't see Michael Jordan. He says, whatever. He just continues with the event. Starts cracking jokes, all that. Michael Jordan finally walks in. He said, okay, let me make a couple jokes about Michael. He makes a joke about his pants. Everybody starts laughing. Ha, ha, ha. He makes another joke. Okay, cool. Everybody laughing a little bit less. He makes another joke. At this point, everybody kind of quiet because they know Michael. Michael, at this point, looking at him like this. But damn, Kevin Hart notices something. The square mustache. Ooh. Oh, he couldn't resist. He said, boy, it looks like you got a thumbprint above your mouth. Damn. Everyone was stone silent. But I assume someone in the back went, so Kevin Hart goes, all right, walks off stage. He shakes Michael Jordan's hand. He's like, man, thanks for inviting me. Michael Jordan grips that boy's hand. He said, thanks for coming. And Michael Jordan hasn't spoken to him since. Now, I'm sure some of you are assuming, oh, well, maybe he just hadn't had the chance to speak to him. Well, you haven't watched the documentary. See, Michael Jordan and his former team, the Chicago Bulls, had a documentary come out about their last season in the NBA together. Now, before this documentary came out, Michael Jordan apparently said he thinks that people will see him differently after this. And well, they did. Because it turns out one of the things that made him such a great player was because he took things so personally. Listen closely. There are YouTube videos dedicated to every single time he said, I took it personally. I took it personally. He took things personally so much. Some nights he would even make up what he took personally. He told people one time this guy on the other team was talking trash about him, so we had to demolish him. Everyone thought this dude was talking smack about Michael. They're like, that's what you get. That's what you get. Michael scoring on you. I even thought this growing up. In the documentary, Michael Jordan like, man, I made that whole thing up. Now, to be fair, he said this just to get the competitive edge, but I just want you to understand his mindset. He also takes things off the court as well. He still seems to have problems with Isaiah Thomas 30 years after their beef. I explained that beef somewhere down there. Anyway, I don't know. I guess that's it, actually. Everybody, y'all want to hear
Michael Jordan's the ultimate grudge holder. Who knew? Don't invite a comedian to roast you if you don't want to get roasted. Well, guys, that's the show for today. We'll be back mañana.